getting used to life at the academy yet? That's good to hear. By the way, tomorrow is another free day. Are you really willing to help out again, like Instructor Sarah said? Thanks a lot, Rean. I really do appreciate it.
Hey there, first year. Oh, it's you. I'm not going to play along with your scams this time, so you might as well be on your way.
I wasn't trying to hustle you before, honest.
Did you, figure out how I did it, though?
If you really want your 50 mirror back, I'll be happy to hand it over.
But wouldn't you rather feel like you earned it? Come on, what do you say?
There had to have been a trick to it. Some form of sleight of hand. Something that wasn't as it seemed. If I had to guess, I'd say the crux of this illusion was... Of course. I'm pretty sure he had a bag at his feet. Which means... You threw the coin in the air, but let it fall instead of trying to catch it. You let it fall right into the open bag lying in wait for it at your feet. Am I right?
Yeah, not bad. Well, I wasn't expecting you to figure it out so quickly.
So I was right.
Yep, spot on. And a promise is a promise, so here's your 50 mirror bag. Sorry. I've only got 10 mirror on me.
Ugh, it's fine. Just forget it. It's only 50 mirror. You can keep it.
Oh, really? Well, that's mighty generous.
Hey! Stop trying to leech money off innocent first years, you louse.
Oh, crap. It's the she-devil.
What? bicycle? No, it looks like it's powered by orbital energy. Wait, I've seen this girl somewhere before.
You're Rean, I take it. I've been hearing all about you from Toa and George. Sounds like you pulled off some pretty amazing stuff in your field study last month.
I'm surprised you know my name, actually. I didn't think I'd been doing anything worthy of such attention. Guess I should still officially introduce myself, though. I'm Rean Schwarzer. It's nice to meet you.
Same. I'm Angelica. Angelica Rodner. Glad I could finally make your acquaintance.
Rodner? As in Marquis Rodner? Head of one of the four great houses?
Same reaction every time, I swear. Yeah, I'm his unworthy daughter. But he doesn't really want to have anything to do with me since I go around dressed like this.
I think it's less how you dress and more how you behave. Where are you going on that bike at this hour anyway?
Oh, George finally finished tuning the orbital engine. So I figured I'd give it a run to the Capitol and back and see how it holds up.
Sure must be nice not to have a care in the world.
Look who's talking.
So you do ride it like a bike. Wow.
Well, catch you later. I'm thinking of putting in a request for you sometime. If I do, I'd sure appreciate a swift response.
Lost for words? That's a little something George put together a while back. He calls it an orbital bike. Pretty cool, huh?
It is. It's kind of like a steel horse. I'm guessing you can't buy those in any shops?
Nah. The Ruhr Institute of Technology started putting that one together as part of a test. Then George finished it off. Jellica put up the money for the parts herself. Oh, but Toa and I helped out too.
Sounds like it must have been a pretty challenging project. Are you on good terms with Toa and George then? Angelica said she'd heard all about me from them. Maybe you had a little something to do with that too?
Well, we're all from different classes, but we've kind of stuck together for a while now. Come to think of it, I never did introduce myself, did I? Name's Crow Armbrust. Second year, Class 5. I'm sure I'll catch you around again. Later!
So, his name's Crow, huh? Angelica's the daughter of Marquis Rodner. Toa's the student council president. George is head of the engineering club. It seems like every second year I meet is somebody important.
Thank you. Onward!
Seems to be a treasure chest here.
Is that a treasure chest? We have nothing to fear!
My turn! Alright, let's do this!
Run. Leave it to me! My turn!
Leave it to me. Go! Flames, gather on my blade! Let's keep moving.
Fire!
We appear to have reached the exit.